Hey, yo, man, what's good with y'all, man? Hey, this your boy, Faye Tyson, man. I ain't gonna lie, born to be a ball player, straight from Northside Zone, Twin City Mass, man. So, man, what's good with y'all, man?
50 Tyson, man, what's good, bro?
Man, I just want to say real quick, shout out to Motivation Hustle, man, for having me, man. You know, it's a blessing, man, from having me on the air, man, on the show, man. You know what I'm saying? I still got your merch, and I do need some more merch.
I got you, man. Appreciate that, man. Man, we've been documenting your journey since the beginning, man. Since you blew up, man. Since you became this the face of Minnesota, I say, man. Because anytime somebody bring up Minnesota, they definitely bring up 50 Tyson.
Yeah, they got to bring up 50 Tyson or Prince. Just like if you search up 50 Cent, you go have to search 50 Tyson. You know what I'm saying?
That's 50 Cent. When you think of 50 Cent, you think of 50 Tyson,
and
right?
And then if you think of Mike Tyson, you think of back to me.
Man, Tyson. Greatness. Ain't nothing but greatness, man. That's what's up, man. So let's take it from the beginning, man. Where you from?
I'm born and raised. I'm from Mass, Minnesota, North Minneapolis. You know, born and raised.
North Minneapolis. Okay, tell us a little bit about how was it growing up in Minneapolis?
Growing up in the hood, North Minneapolis, it was a struggle growing up. You know, my dad was in and out of my life, and then my mom, she had to work every day. And then my siblings, my older sister used to always have to watch us in the house. Okay. If my mom had to work and where my dad, wherever, because you know, my dad's a mechanic, he fixed cars, and sometimes he's back and forth. And then, you know, it'd be my older sister watching us in the house. So, and around this time, and when it comes down to the 90s, though, the 90s was just like a struggle, because when it comes down to me going through daycares, going through like trials, tribulation, and you just going through a lot of things going on around you, because you know, only thing I'm thinking about is video games, toys, and candy and food. That's all that you think about.
And you're the oldest out of seven siblings?
I'm one of the six siblings, but I'm the oldest boy on my mom's side.
Okay, so you got a sister older than you?
My older sister is older than me.
Okay.
I got two older sisters. One of them is way older than me. One of them is like a year older than me. You know what I'm saying? It's like six of us. It's like three sisters and three brothers.
Okay. And so how was that? So you said mom was always at work and dad was in and out the house.
Yeah.
So was it hard going to school and stuff? Like, how was it like having autistic, right?
Yeah.
Was it growing up having autism and you know, dealing with that disability as a kid?
Man, I ain't gonna lie, man. Me born in the 90s, man. First I can remember, you know, like they said that, you know, when I was at school, you know, autism, you know, born and diagnosed in the 90s, they said that I had it. When I was in the doctor, they told my mom I have autism because I had trouble staying focused. I had trouble being still. I had trouble just moving around. It was just what I was going through in the 90s, though. You know what I'm saying?
You had it at first, right?
I didn't know I had it at first.
Okay.
It took me a while just to understand what that was. Well, autism, what I had, but that's what I was told.
Okay.
I was strong as a kid in the kid of the 90s.
Did you used to get bullied about it, or how was it?
I used to get bullied about it, though. I used to get called all types of things, special ed, slow, retarded, span, all types of stuff. I was getting that throwback 2000. That was way worse than I was going through in the 90s. You know what I'm saying? 90s.
You feel like the 90s as a kid was worse?
I said for me, I was saying throwback 2000.
Oh, okay.
I was getting fights, I was getting through a lot of. Lot of drama and stuff.
So when you used to get bullied, you didn't know how to control your anger and stuff?
You
just used to get in fights?
Yeah, I used to I used to always ignore the most part of it, get in fights and stuff, and get into like, you know, I used to always have to let my mom know what's going on at school, or let her know what's going on out there, because I used to always go outside and play with other people, like, you know, as a kid, you know, when you kid, just like these other kids, you go want to play, get to know everybody and stuff, just have fun, just enjoy life, you know?
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay, so let's talk about the name 50 Tyson. Where did that come from? Did you always have it as a kid, or did it come at a later age?
You know, at the time I had MySpace. I came up with the name of 50 Tyson at the age of 15, 2008. But around this time, I wasn't doing open mic shows and nothing like that. You know, when I came up with the name of 50 Tyson, the reason behind it, because when I used to work at Trust Hospital, Team Teamworks, and then I used to work. You know what I'm saying? McDonald's and Lake Street around the time. They used to always tell me, what up, 50? What up, Tyson? 50? Billy? They used to spit the verse. People say, what up, 50? 50 all the time. And then I had to take off the set, took out the money, just call 50 Tyson. And then...
So they used to say the 50 Cent verse to you?
Yeah.
The 50...
Billy, at football practice, it was crazy, man. It was just wild. Afterwards, people used to spit the freestyle after practice. From then, you know, throwing to us, it was just crazy.
Man.
It was fun back then in them days, man. Football practice, all types of stuff, man. People don't even understand it.
So you used to have fun with it. You didn't take it too serious. You didn't take it.
I wasn't doing none of that. No studio time, nothing like that back then. Not yet.
Okay. So you was working during high school?
Yes. From 08 through 2010, my first real job I worked was McDonald's on Lake Street, 2 days Lake Street.
And this was before you started the rap career?
Yeah, that was before my music career, yes.
And people were still calling you 50 Tyson?
2008.
But that wasn't your name, though, right? But
yeah.
People were still calling you that.
People would just call me 50 and call me Tyson. It wasn't like they called me 50 Tyson directly like that.
Okay.
Not yet.
He was just Antonio.
I just came up with the name of Fig Tyson.
Okay.
Yeah.
You were still Antonio.
Still Antonio in 2008, correct.
Okay. So, when did you decide to upload a freestyle and call yourself 50 Tyson?
It takes me back to February 2009.
You was out of high school?
Yeah. I was still in high school. Like, in my sophomore year, I was doing a freestyle. I was like... Hey, yo, man, this your boy, Fig Tyson. And I was literally just posting the video up randomly. So I was just doing it for the fun of it, just messing around and stuff. I was like, I ain't gonna say that I'm Fig Tyson. I'm from North Side, that's where I'm from. I ain't gonna lie, but I'm Fig Tyson. I was just saying, just crazy thing as a normal kid would do, man, in my teen days, man.
And you would upload it on?
YouTube.
On YouTube and yeah. MySpace?
YouTube and MySpace, you're correct. YouTube and MySpace, yeah.
Okay, so when you did your freestyle, the freestyle was called just 50 Tyson?
Yeah, or I just on the title, on the video, if you look on the video on YouTube, it was just called 50 Tyson.
Okay, so when you uploaded, did it go up right away, or did it take a couple months?
It took a year.
A year?
Like, yeah, it took like a year, I would say, a year. Because 2009, it was just a start, you know what I'm saying? And then I would say 2010, that's when it got
took off. What happened when you was like, "It's I'm out of here, I'm famous"? Like, what did you see that was like, okay, I'm this is for real?
Around August 2010.
What happened?
Like, you know, I started featuring on Kevin Hart channel, featuring on Tosh.0.
So did Kevin Hart, who was the first celebrity to say something to you?
The first celebrity, I would say Kevin Hart.
Kevin Hart was the first biggest celebrity say something. And what did he do? What was
Kevin Hart, he was just like, it's Fig Tyson. You might see me all blue. He was pretty much doing a mockery freestyle, like just pretend like he was me, just spoof love, showing love, support.
Okay. So, when you seen that, how did you feel?
Man, I was just excited, too happy. I was just like, damn, we getting somewhere. Like, I was like, damn. I was just too happy as a kid. Me being 17 at the time, I was just like, wow, like, this is amazing. But, like, this is just...
Like, you haven't had this much attention before? Like, this is crazy?
Yeah, man. I was like, man, rest is history, man. I was just like, man.
So, after Kevin Hart, just lots of celebrities just kept coming towards, kept reacting and redoing your freestyle?
It was like different random people doing spoof freestyle, but I did get a lot of celebrity love on Twitter too. People were just posting like different things, and then I was about 50 Tyson. And like around 2009, it was just a little bit, just still Antonio.
Mm-hmm.
But 2010, that's when I became 50 Tyson.
You start going to school and at work, and people was calling you 50 Tyson. What were some stuff people would say when they seen you?
Hey, is you Fig Tyson? Hey, Fig Tyson. Hey, oh my God, it's really Fig Tyson. What's up, bro? Hey, can we get a bitch? You know what I'm saying? It was just rest of history, though, man. I made a change, and, you know, I remember Jasmine Moreland and her, I don't know her cousin, but her friend Michelle, they were managers at McDonald's. They came up to me like, hey, we saw your freestyle. I see you trying to rap now and everything. I was like, Damn. even the people at McDonald's are spreading rumors. It's just rumors going around. Dang, that's 50 Tyson.
That's 50 Tyson.
Dang, that's 50 Tyson.
So, do you think people started coming to McDonald's to see 50 Tyson?
Not really. I ain't really.
You ain't really think. You know what I'm saying?
I post a few pictures of myself. Like 50 Tyson worked there, but it wasn't like.
So when did you decide to leave? When did it become too much? And you was like, I gotta get out of here.
You know, I quit around the summertime 2010.
Okay.
I quit around that time, around September. No. I would say around August 2010. I had to quit for a reason, not because of the 50 Tyson thing. Uh-huh. At the end of the day, it was just, I ain't like the store manager, the way
the
they
rushed. Oh, okay. The way they was just treating
you. Treating people, and you, treating me and stuff.
Yeah, you too, you becoming famous. You becoming popular.
The 50 Tyson. When I realized, okay, if I'm making all this money from t-shirts now, I got Chris helping me up. If I've got this 50 Tyson glory and everything, I don't even need this.
They don't need no job.
Yes. Like, bro, I'm already.
I'm out of here.
I feel like I can make a chunk change already. I wasn't getting paid enough working there. They used to always have me working on the weekends, just my Saturday and Sundays, but mostly on the Saturday. I'm like, man, this ain't enough.
This ain't that, yeah.
They only do that to me because I was in high school at the time, but I was like, man, I worked at the age of 15, quit at the age of 17. First, I was like, man, y'all can have this. I'm good. I'm straight.
So you got the fame. You got Kevin Hart. So now, did you decide to become like a full-time rapper after you quit?
Full-time rapper. I became a full-time rapper.
And did you drop a project first?
Yes.
Or did you get signed first?
I got signed on Hustle Records first.
After you quit? So after you quit McDonald's, you got signed by Hustle Records?
Yep.
And then you dropped the I Ain't Gonna Lie?
5-1 mixtape hosted by DJ Who Kid.
Okay, DJ Who Kid. How'd you get up with him? That's what's up. He's a legend.
Man, I ain't gonna lie. Back in November 30 of 2010, I did my first show in New York. He invited me to come to his TV show called The Radio Planet in downtown New York. And I got an interview on the show for the first time. And I guess him and Troy Hudson must have changed words behind my back. I don't know what was going on. Till this day, I believe Troy Hudson reached out to Who Kid, or Who Kid probably heard about him. Get 50 Tyson on the show, most definitely.
Okay.
And boom, I ended up getting on his show, and boom, you know what I'm
saying? Okay, that's for sure.
Went crazy, and then he decided to host my mixtape, boom.
And you dropped it.
Dropped it, though.
And it go crazy. It
went crazy after that, you know?
And then you get something from 50 Cent.
50 Cent was so crazy, too. Like, you know, he shot me out on the tweet, and it was just crazy. It was just like, oh, he said that nigga looked just like me, shit. it was just crazy, though, man.
And did you ever get a chance to meet him?
I met 50 Cent. Around 2010s, I ain't meet 50 Cent in person around that time. But
okay.
I met him 2 years ago recently. 2 years ago, back in August, when I met him at the Hy-Vee and BP, we had a big ass meet and greet.
What'd he say when he first seen
you? He was like, 50 Tyson, what up with you? I was like, what up, 50? You know what I'm saying? Who was shining worth 50 to 50?
50 to 50.
50 to 50, man. You know, he would just congrats me, was telling me to keep doing my thing and everything, and I assume with the power and categorize what he's doing and stuff to BMF, and that was it. You know what I'm saying? You know, I salute his drinks he's doing with the FN, that's called FN.
Man, so now you got all this fame, you got the mixtape going, you got all these celebrities coming at you, man, you got all this stuff coming at you so fast. Is there any girls you running into, relationships? Like, I seen a lot of relationships you was in. Oh, I seen a lot of girls that you was dealing with, man, during this journey of yours.
Man, I ain't gonna lie.
How was that, man?
When I was in high school, you know, I wasn't in a real relationship in high school. I wasn't, like, before the 50 Tyson fan, I was dealing with females, but I wasn't, like, in a real relationship like that. But, you know, around the fame, time around this, like we in 2010-11.
Right, right. You 50 Tyson now.
Yeah, I'm 50 Tyson
now. So now you got girls coming at you.
Girls coming at me, females coming at me, pictures.
And relationships.
Relationships, all types, man. It was just crazy though, man. People was like, what up best friend, what up friend, what up? What up, boo? What up, baby? What up, love? And everything. It was just like, I was just getting all this love left to right, left to right. And then, you know what I'm saying? All that I can say, man, you know, rest is history, man. Like, all I can do is just get a laugh from it. Like, this.
Like, did you get, like, did a lot of girls try to, like, take advantage of you? How did you feel about this? Like,
man, like, when it comes down, like, especially the culture of Minnesota, man, we already know how females is here, man. It's just ridiculous, man. Nah, I ain't really had nobody take advantage of me around this point, though. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Just like when Nurse Stark got involved with me around this time, toward August 2010, I thought we went out in a relationship. And then I was like, nah, we don't go out. We just friends. She was just around me because we was signed with the same label with Hudson Records at the time. And then we went out, we fucked, and all types of stuff. Everyone was spread rumors. Like, damn, they tried their study, let's go out and everything. I'm like, nah, but we is the same age in real life. You know, we both 30, but at the same time, and I'm like, you know, we just cool. But nowadays, you know, she doing her own thing, doing her own thing, you know.
Okay.
Really talk like that, like we was too, but like we used to. But the Icy, though, did took off, man. Icy took the song to another level. Mm-hmm. I still be getting feedback with the Icy to this day between me and her. But yeah, man.
Okay.
Other than that, though, a lot of people thought, but I was dating her at the time, but nah, but I was talking to another female. She was I had a female world star named Aaron Denise, a.k.a. Miss Freddie Tyson, R.P. Long Live Tour, though, before anything. She was doing, like, world star candy, and she was showing her titties, showing her private parts. She was showing her body out and everything. And then people telling me, like, this girl on world star cards, so Miss Freddie Tyson. And then it was just crazy. And then I reached out to her on Facebook, trying to figure out who this person is. And I realized on Facebook, she go by Aaron Denise. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking to her on the phone. I'm just like, asking, like, what's going on? What's up with this video? What's up? What's going on? Everything. You got my face looking at this crazy. They was like, man, that's too much. You got something this and that. It was a back and forth. But she admitted that she did it for my attention because she liked me. She wanted to be in a relationship with me one day and everything. And then she talked about, she admitted that she would have a baby for me one day and all types of stuff. She was talking about everything, because she stayed all the way down there in Atlanta at the time, though. And then, you know what I'm saying, we was talking all this lovey-dovey. This, like, takes us back, like, this is, like, around November 2010, around the springtime, around 2011, too. And then, man, we on the phone every day talking. Skype was popping that time. You know, we was talking on video on Skype, man. We was talking to each other on Twitter. But, you know, I was using Twitter as much, like I right. said, but, you know, I had my manager running my Twitter at the time, but I was talking to her a lot on Facebook, man.
How did it end?
Like, man, we had a fallout around the summertime, but this takes us back, like, man, like around, man, like I would say like June or July 2011, because she thought I didn't like her no more. She thought I was, like, you know what I'm saying? She thought I was being fake towards her, and she thought that I was being disloyal. But what really made me and her have a fallout was because the prom, because, you know, every year is a senior prom, mm-hmm. and then she wanted to come to Minnesota to go to prom with me, but I thought around this time I didn't know somebody, you know, like I didn't know you could bring an outside person who don't go to Edison to a prom. I'm like, wait a minute. I see people invite other people to the prom, and then, damn, Aaron Denise was right the whole time. I should have brought her. So she was going to fly her own money here. She was going to fly here to Minnesota. And then I was like, damn, because around this time, I'm already going through a family situation. They are, and then I'm already going through a label situation a little bit. It was a lot mixing the drama in the mix. I ain't want her to be caught up in the mix. And so I told her to stay back.
So you just had to end that and end it?
Not like we end it, though. But she looking at it like, I don't want to be Miss Faye Tyson no more. I think you just saying this and that. And it just turned to an argument.
Though. Okay, you wouldn't you with
went,
that.
Things went left. Yeah. Last time I spoke to her on the phone was 2011.
And then the last relationship, LaRonda.
Yeah, LaRonda, man. You know, LaRonda, she got involved in the mix. Like how I met her, that takes us back to to the October 2012. When I first met LaRonja, I met her at the Res Lounge, you know what I'm saying? It was an open mic night, you know what I'm saying? It was a lot of different artists perform. I performed 50 Years Back, because 50 Years Back was my best hit song
that I did
in 2012.
And she stepped up to you after that?
Like around this time, me and LaRonja, we wasn't even talking to each other like that.
Oh, okay.
She literally came up to me, just asked for a picture. And then that was it.
How did you guys get serious?
You asked me how I met her. We got in a serious relationship around the summertime. This takes us back like summertime of 2013. This was like August 2013. You know what I'm saying? The reason why we ended up making it official because she was telling me about how much she loved me, how much she cared about me. And then she said that she had to stick up for me at the bar when people speaking bad about my name and speaking bad about me and stuff. Cause you know, she be going to bars and stuff, East St. Paul, it'd be a lot of activity, a lot of shit going on, and she'd be around that environment. You know, I'm in North Minneapolis.
She was your trap queen?
No, I wouldn't say trap queen, but I was just, at the end of the day, I believe she was all that, you know what I'm saying? Because I was hearing good things and bad things about her.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Some people was saying, like, you shouldn't fuck with nobody like that. Man, she a hoe. Hey, she be flirting with everybody, doing no cocaine and all this stuff. And then some people say good things, like, yeah, man, she cool as hell. Hey, man, y'all be a good couple. Hey, y'all might have kids, have babies one day. Like, it was just going back and forth.
Okay, it became too much for you?
Yeah, man. But when we got in a relationship, you know what I'm saying? We was just manifestial, you know what I'm saying? We started hugging out and everything. But around 2014, we still in a relationship. But we had a fallout around the summertime, June 2015, because she started going out with somebody I didn't know about until that. He went by solo trip, you know what I'm saying? She was dating him at the time, and I'm like, damn, I'm like, he ain't even tell me what's going on with him, he ain't tell me what's going on, and then she admitted that she was trying to set me up in some type of way, because she started thinking that I didn't love her no more, because she was just making shit up, because, you know, she kind of moved out of Minnesota for a little bit around the time, because she started staying in Texas a little bit, and then she moved back here, around 2015, around January 2015, without me knowing, but she reached out to me back in April 2015, say she back, but I'm like, you been back, because people already told me you came back, you know what I'm saying, the word goes up, the word gets around every day, you know what I'm saying, about you, people word gets about me, you know what I'm saying.
So where you at now, are you just single, like, are you looking for a girl, or like,
what you know what I'm saying, like, me personally, like, I live a single life, outside of music, I live a single life with no kids. LaRonja, she lived a single life with no kids too. Like, she flirts with a lot of people, you know, that's the life she lived. Like me, I flirt with people, I flirt with, I like women, I'm straight, you know what I'm saying? But I flirt with a lot of females too, but the thing is, the difference between that is, you know, I do it on the business side, but I try not to get too personal, because I'm like, that's how you mess yourself, and get caught up in the matrix, all types of bullshit come your way. You know, they want to get to the mind and all this, but all that weird shit start happening.
Exactly. You start to mix shit and shit get weird.
Man. But shout out to her though. LaRonja Bass, a.k.a. Ginger Spice 305,
Spice 305, yep.
Yeah, man. Yeah, they the same people, but shout out to her though. Like, I don't even talk to her. I talked to her last month a little bit.
Did you see the video of her on the TV show? Baddies
Club? She was on the Baddies East audition in Virginia, man. When I first seen that Torque audition, man, I started doing this. I started shaking my head. I started laughing. Like, man, what the hell is I'm saying, man? Like, you got everybody talking. We got the whole Minnesota. Like some people just saying, like, you know, I just shook my head and started laughing. And like I told her on the phone, man, whatever you do, just keep it going. I know you didn't make it to your audition. You know, she still can get people vote, but I don't think a lot of people vote for her because she didn't make the cut. You know, Lil London, I told her she was the one who made her tour. And then LaRonja doesn't matter to her because she made her tour. If it wasn't for her maybe tour, I would have did it. Because LaRonja, see, you know what I'm saying? The years I know her, before I met her, around 2010 through 2012. She was a stripper at the time. I think she was working at Centers at the time. You know, Centers strip club used to be lit back in the day. I think she was working there. But around this time, I didn't know her. I didn't know her at all. Okay. I knew her around 2012 when I first met her at the Rest Lounge. But we got in a serious relationship around 2013. We started talking every, like, I'm going to be real. We was, when I was going to Transition Plus, because I did 2 years Transition Plus, she would literally call me like every single day, 24/7, asking the same question. Hey, Williams, what you doing? What else you doing? Hey, baby, what you doing? Hey, baby, call me. Hey, what you doing after school type shit? It was just crazy. It was, that, like, that's why I feel like it was real. I was, cause I did, like, I ain't gonna lie though, like, when you in Minnesota though, I, you know, for her being the paw, being the app, I was like, man, I've never in my life been in a serious relationship like this before, ever. Because, you know, Mirage was like literally like the first female I ever dated in Minnesota out of all females. Most females I dealt with, I just flirt with them a little bit. We might, like, you might have sex with them, but that don't mean you go out with them. One night stand, that's it. But other than that, Mirage was the only female I dated in Minnesota.
Man, damn, that's dope, man.
But yeah, shout out to her though, man, whatever she got going on though. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I just stick it. So I just stay to the grind and the money put God first before anything.
That's dope, man. That's dope, man. I'm glad to see you happy, man. I'm glad to see you back. You still around. You still making moves. You just dropped a song. Can you tell us what that is?
Man, Lane music video. You know, a lot of people don't know is that Lane is just a music video I did. It was Lane official music video. Like, you know what I'm saying? You know, it was shot and edited by Leon Mitchell from Level Films, and then it was mixed and mastered by Dion Kelly from Dear Mama Studios. And then, you know, how the music video came about was, like, you know, I reached out to my boy Too Much, and then I told him, like, hey, we need to use your spot for the location for the video, and then I came up with that idea. You know, I'm not a lean person. I don't drink lean in real life. I'm not a lean person. That was just a gimmick as a prank a little bit. Cause you know, most people when they use real lean in the video, they be having codeine and jelly wrench, all types of shit in their bottle in their lean. But I just used that NyQuil medicine to make it look like it was lean bottle. We just ripped the top off and then boom, you know, I just literally pour a little bit in the Sprite bottle, Too Much, put a little bit in his bottle, in my bottle. Boom, we just make it look like we just turned up having fun. And then it was just crazy, man. Like, a lot of people really fall for, like, it was real, though. And I was like, damn, many Tyson, this is not you. This is not your image. Hey, 50, man, who got you doing drugs, doing lean? I'm like, man, what is y'all talking about? I ain't have no real lean. I don't even buy lean in real life. It was just crazy. It was just, I just felt like doing it because it was a good gimmick, though, man. But I just did it for the fun, out of love for the fans and everything, just to be entertained, man.
That's dope, man. That's dope. So that's good. You still putting out music. You got your social media back up and running. You not in a relationship no more. So what is next for 50 Tyson?
Man, what's next for your boy 50 Tyson, man? I'm still dropping another music video. I'm finna do another music video shoot. This next music video show I'm finna do, it's like it's September 2nd. It's called I Work Hard, Then I Grind Hard. I work so hard every day, like me featuring Levitate. You know, some people call her Angel. We finna do another music video shoot shot by the same director, Level Films. And then as far as new songs, I am working on another EP. It's called Northside Zone Volume 2, the EP. It's gonna be out real soon on DistroKid. It's gonna be pushed to all social media platforms. It's gonna go crazy. And then I'm also I'm working on getting to the movies. You know what I'm saying? That's my next stuff. He tries to do movies for the first time, even though I just gotta find the right people getting an audition. Like, my next stuff, because, you know, for me being 30 now, and I've been doing all this music videos for years, first I was like, my next stuff, I need to get to acting. Because if I see 50 Cent to do it, and my dads to do it, and they see 50 Tyson in the mix, boom, it's over.
It's over.
You know, my next stuff is getting to the movies, man. Whatever, it don't matter if it's PG-13, rated R, or PG, whatever, TVMA, whatever. I just try to go where the buddies that I can fit, like Lil Bro, Lil Skip. It's going to go crazy once they see me in part of it. Boom, there you go.
Okay, man.
You know what I'm saying? That's my next stuff right now. Hey, yo, man, this your boy, Faye Tyson. I just want to say real quick, shout out to Motivation to Hustle, man, for having me on the air, man. It's a pleasure for being on the show, man. I understand. Thanks for y'all having me. But my social media. Make sure y'all follow my new Instagram for right now, Official Fitty Tyson. And please report Fitty Tyson Official 12. Please report that. But hit me up on YouTube. My YouTube is Fitty Tyson. Subscribe, hit that link, button with the bell. And then also, man, add me on Facebook, Antonio Henderson Davis, Antonio Devonta Davis, and Tyson Manny Howler. And then also, man, go like my fan page on Facebook. You already know, the real Fitty Tyson. And follow me on Twitter at Fitty Tyson Official. Follow me on TikTok, Fitty Tyson Official. And then, you know, make sure y'all cup your merch. I got my Fitty Tyson merch. Go to 50lg.myspressures.com and 50tyson.myspressures.com. And then just follow me on all social media platforms and Clubhouse Fitty Tyson Official. You already know, man. Everywhere you can see Fitty Tyson, you already know.